as good as you thought. Let's use them. Close enough now that you're it's not worth it for you to do this or keep something more careful. Overkill? Absolutely. If it hit, it would be overkill. Dark week yet. And that's the match. Or not. Alright, change position there because I don't want the falling damage. like embarrassing where like you crit and then the falling damage happens, but it does not have to kill him.
I mastered time itself. I could not stop my own time from coming.
There. There we go. Up. Now, I should be able to advance the side quest. There we go. Unum Riva, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yes, Denim.
At the Hega Bonhamuba, Sherry mentioned something called the Apocrypha.
The Apocrypha? I can't say I'm familiar.
Dark Knights are a formidable foe. We'd burn ourselves well if we were to confront them. We know this ability. The Apocrypha grimoires our possession. The odds shift in our favor. Tell me where they can be found.
The Apocrypha are kept hidden for a reason. They contain a dreadful power, more than any man should. I know of one such a man. King Broderick of Brigantis. In the final days of Drogalia's great war, Broderick gave the Apocrypha in a desperate attempt to turn the tide of battle. His foes were wiped from the face of the earth, his own armies with him. None save the Invoker survived.
Not to cure the king, cure the king. Use the Apocrypha at every turn.
You may not know this, but Brigantia Flats was once a lush and fertile highland. The Apocrypha transformed it into the desolate waste it is today. Not even the laws of nature can resist.
In the very end, it was the Apocrypha that brought down Broderick. Even as he won the war, he lost the love of his people. After the war's end, King Dugalia ordered the Apocrypha sealed. Danger in the Apocrypha is not the knowledge itself, you see, rather how it is used.
Roderick is up these hills. Do you think you will fare better? Okay. Open up the side quest. I will need to say, I know I will. I'm not King Roderick. I've never used such power so capriciously. If that's the way you will lead, I'm obliged to follow. Made a proclamation of secret throughout the Isles. I know the location of those six. There are some prime temples in each command of the enemies. Remaining two, light and dark, I know nothing. I had heard that the six great fortresses of Valyria were those temples. I saw nothing at any of them that would house so great an artifact. Of course not. I sealed them where unknowing eyes would not find them. The opening the temple doors requires an oracle. Who are these oracles? The daughters of the Abuna who forged the seal. Your daughters? Put them with you to each of the fortresses and the way will open. Touched by the goddess of the temple, they may be made into an oracle, though they will serve you well in battle regardless. Okay, so again, I don't really know how to go with it because it's again, it comes up. Character I'm planning to have go to Oracle is probably going to be Olivia. So we are, because Sherry's spell selection is different enough from my up from Islington's that having both of them in the party works well. They change things up a bit. They give some range, more range. On the other hand, Olivia's a healer, and we've got three of them already. So I think Olivia is probably the best choice for or change the oracle. Oh, great Nesthrot, goddess of lightning, admit me into your sacred, onto your sacred sanctum. All right. It's 9:00. I will pick this up next.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please like and subscribe. Also, consider backing my Patreon. Patreon backers get episodes up to 1 week early of this show and also, please consider backing my Coffee Cup. Coffee Cup Box also helps support the show and it's not a money-down.